More often than not, entrepreneurs are taught to be very stubborn, have grit, and be very focused on their particular vision or mission. That's true, but I also think they have to be exceptionally open-minded, exceptionally agile. And that's where having an immigrant mindset is really, really important. That's how most immigrants survive or thrive when they land in a new area. And I would think an immigrant, an entrepreneur, is very much the same. I'm Avak Kahvejian. I'm a general partner at Flagship, and I lead an origination team to start new biotech companies.
He's been here for over a decade, and during that time, he's been involved in many, many different projects, the most famous of which is the COVID-19 vaccine.
He was in the room when Moderna got started. He was here at Flagship when dozens of companies got started.
Flagship incubates a company, and then after 3-4 years, you know, they hire a CEO, that CEO hires a leadership team, then they go out and bring additional investors, and then they become a freestanding company.
And those companies have employed people, they have saved lives with their medicines, they have brought talent to New England and the region and the country. And so Avak, by his very work, has helped to make the country a better place.
By creating new companies, we are essentially creating new vehicles for jobs and highly skilled jobs. It's an opportunity to perpetually employ people and to grow rapidly in the community, many of them coming from many, many different parts of the world.
Avak grew up in an immigrant family, and therefore, and in an Armenian immigrant family, which kind of comes with a certain amount of a sense of obligation to the past, which is for us filled with injustice, but not uniquely. There's lots of different people who bring along a past of injustice, but that propels you to act, not just to fix the injustices, but to create a better situation for the people who follow.
Armenians have a very long history that goes back thousands of years. But one of our defining moments in the 20th century was the genocide that occurred in 1915.
1.5 million perished during the death march, during this genocide. And those who escaped, those who survived, they spread all over the world.
Every generation in my family has had to move. And it started with my great-grandparents after the genocide. They moved from what is historical Armenia, now Eastern Turkey, to Syria. Then from Syria, another group moved to Beirut, Lebanon, where I was born and my parents were born. And then from there, during the Civil War, we left in a hurry and moved to Canada, ending with us here in the United States.
Armenians, wherever they go, they build a church. And next to the church, they build a school.
The St. Stephen's Armenian Elementary School allows Armenian children to learn together, to get to know one another, and to learn their language and get in touch with their identities.
He served first as a member of the board and then as chairman of the board. He made sure that his children get Armenian education.
And I said, "Is there anybody who might be a good candidate for the board?" And he said, "Avak." And our services consist of resettlement. We have education programming for immigrant and refugee adults. Then we have career services. And then we have an immigration legal services program. Avak has challenged us to think more creatively about how we can sustain our organization and grow it.
I hope for a world in which we are all much more multicultural. I strive to encourage that in everything I do, encourage that in my behavior, encourage that in my kids, and to impart that on the people I work for.
Avak is a person that feels a responsibility to make an impact to others and to make an impact in the world. And I think that speaks to his generous spirit.
It's difficult for me to describe Avak as any one thing, but I think as a combination of things, he ends up kind of standing out. I would say that if he was doing athletics, he'd be good at a decathlon.
With someone like Avak, it's never about himself. He's not driven by himself or some type of self-satisfaction. He's driven by a sense of a mission and how he is part of a mission. He's an instrument of a mission to leave a better world behind.